Kamusta everyone? David, Zero ang pangkalako, kaibigan, si Yololi. I'm just kidding. This is not a Tagalog channel. This is the English stream. My name is Zero. My co-caster today is Yololi, and we will be going into the first map between Bren and Morph.
Honestly, I was a little bit concerned too. I was like, oh my god, Darwin can speak a different tongue, but at the same time, I can't understand what he's talking about. Actually, I'm just kidding. I know what exactly he's talking about. But yeah, anyway, thank you all so much for joining us on this stream. This is going to be our third BO2 of today, and it's going to be between Bren Esport versus Morph Esports. How are you feeling about that game though?
Yeah, Bren Esports, they just came off a very tight series between AHQ, one of the favorites of this entire tournament, and they drew 1-1. I think Morph has it coming to them. This is one of the toughest series they'll play throughout this entire tournament, and they have to come up big with everything they have in order to move on from this group stage.
Yeah, but also at the same time, for all you viewers as well who wasn't really joining us from literally at 12 o'clock today, SGT, by the way.
Yeah.
So we have the first game, which was Morph between Enter. They tied the round between 1-1. Our second one, BSQ and Brand.
That was a big one.
Oh, that was a big one. 1-1 as well. Very close game. By the way, finally, third BO2 is finally underway on the first map of Haven, and it's going to be Brand Esports map pick.
Yeah, it was Bren Esports win as well against HQ. Ooh. And that was a huge win. 13-7 was the scoreline. Dubstep and Dispenser was absolutely ginormous in this map, and I think they would be able to do it again.
Oh yeah, but also don't forget about Ching as well from Bren Esports in that last game, that 1v2, not really a 1v2, but it's a 1v2 on the C point, but he held it down. The Twitch chat, everyone was going absolutely nuts. They were like, Ching,
I was going nuts. Yeah, and this is the first pistol round of the first map. And looking at the setup here, it's still pretty loose. Bren Esports, this is one of their favorite maps, and they have they're going to play on the attacking side, the favorites of this side, and let's see how they are going to do as they are poised around mid.
And it's nice and slow and steady, does win the race as well. By the way, coming from the A side, we already see the Sova already from the side here, Morph Esports. They already engaged their owl drone to try to scout out that A shot towards their Sova. I'm pretty sure they already spot out the Cypher, but it's not a good reason enough for them to really push forward just yet. This is the first one. It's going to be pissed around where it's very crucial for both of these teams here, because whoever wins this pistol round will get that gun advantage in the second one.
Yeah, look what they're doing. Morph is really smart. They're pushing aggressively into a sewer, making sure that this is only a lurker, not any sort of Mimula. Dubstep going in. He dives in. He does flash. Oh, Jesse Flash gets the opening. Gets the second as well. Oh, Kurt will stop. As well, gets a double on towards Dubstep and Ching, and it's back to a 3v3. Bren Esports, they're putting on the brakes. They are stopping this for the moment. But look at this. They have Colin. Dispenser is in B, and no one else is in there as well. They're rotating the spike all the way towards A.
Oh,
look at Dispenser right behind him. Gets famous. That's going to even out the odds. That's going to leave the advantage towards the side of Bren and Dispenser. Can he come up big with 2 more kills as he stops the rotation and the spike is just going down?
Planted. Oh man, Spice has been planted as well towards his A side. Now it all comes down to the retake. But Morph is one man shot, but he didn't actually spot Jesse Vash as he was looking from a different angle. But here comes the spike and to try to scout things out. Beautiful place as well. So this is going to be allowing him to watch that A lane entrance. But the last member of Morph, he's not going to go through from there. Khan is actually going to come through from the heaven to deliver that divine judgment and punishment. Getting ready to jump down, instantly making quite a bit more. Get the fall damage and Borkum will be able to punish him for it with a beautiful headshot with the ghost.
Great decision there by Bren, knowing when to rotate, knowing when to stop pushing into C, and they just went all the way towards A. That got them the spike down. Dispenser with a huge lurk got a kill on towards Famous before he was able to do anything else, and that just gave the first round towards Bren. On the attacking side, they're going to be able to buy up in this round, and let's look at the buy here. It's going to be a full eco buy, a full eco round coming from the side of Morph. Well, for Bren, they are opting to save actually some of the guns. They're not going to buy up. Oh, looks like they are. Ching might be seeing something else, but they are playing with 2 ghosts and 3 rifles here.
Yep, and the best part about it, they're not gonna go for the full anti eco round either. They're gonna be bringing up a lot of rifles, bulldogs, vandals, phantoms as well as the contents here. Ooh, beautiful reaction coming from Jesse Vash, but then again he saw the trajectory and was able to pick this up. Ooh, he was able to go for the tag, but the rotation coming from Freya was not really on for them. Porka with the bulldog, gonna go for the trade down, catching up 2 members. And Dispenser on the other hand will be cancelling the rotation coming out from Famous. Last man standing, Fiddle Wall, scratch that, because Morkum gonna seal his fate with 3 men's heads. in this second round.
Yeah, smart play coming from Brand there, using the Jesse Vash, who didn't have any guns, only the ghost to lurk. So even if he dies, he only loses just that ghost. So he didn't lose out on too much. He didn't have a great armor as well. So it was just a lurking role. And Jesse Vash, he got one kill before he died, got the information that there was a lot in a sewers, and everyone just went C. And that just gave the second round towards Brand. But this is where it matters. First spy round, Morph has an operator on Cud, while Ching has one for himself.
I also love the fact that one of the members of Brand Esports is still going to be sticking with the boulder, but look at the initiation coming in with the fault line trying to try as they secure this A long, slowly pushing towards the side here. I love the rest of the member trying to reposition towards that cover, and Dubstep has his side towards his corner and Haven. But look at it, right at the last minute as Freya finds one, go for the tag, but Senate was not able to get the pickup. Dubstep, Tailswind below Haven, spots out A lane, sees the cloud drill, but get tagged instead. Drops out the cloud drill for good measure, but Freya has a rival and with Freya. The full spray, he gets the Dubstep.
Perfectly timed there from Freya, knowing that where is wallbangable. You saw him walk towards near the windows and he got the kill. That's gonna help them out in this retake quite a bit as it's down to a 4v5. The post-plant position though is perfect coming from the side of Brand. They have all stations covered. Oh, the operator gets one kill. Cut gets one. Dispenser will not be able to get the cut as well. Second kill goes down. Batman with the famous though. Strikes and Dispenser. Can he do it again? We've seen huge plays coming by him, but no, not enough. Batman will stop him in his tracks and the defuse will come in. Morph is able to get themselves on the board and get the defuse.
Oh, so unfortunate as well. He was trying to buy a little bit more time when he committed the dismiss with the intangible. And once he got out of it, he was hoping because his weapon, his Phantom, actually didn't really have much much ammo either.
Yeah.
He went for the swap with the operator, but it just took too long for it to reset to allow it to pick up anybody.
Great effort there coming from the side of Dispenser, getting 3 kills all by his lonesome. And last man standing, having to ace that round to win, that was a tough ask. He tried his best here, but they are still able to play here. They have four rifles here from the side of Bren, while it's still going to be a full buy coming from the side of Morph.
Still holding on the line. One Spectre in the hand of Morph Esport as well. But then again, this is one of the moments where Cut and the rest of the team members of Morph Esport has to really step up. And they pretty much did in the third round, which really turned the tide towards their favor. But Brand Esport still 1 point ahead. Aldro is going to be more silly. I think the right word is expire here in this case.
Yeah, it poofed.
My god, and speaking of poof, Borkum poofing, making all kinds of magic towards famous here. Now tying things down to a 4v5. One defender short on the other side. Sorry, scratch that, make it two as well as Dispenser picking up members one by one with his rotation routes.
Yeah, Dispenser has just been catching all these aggressive pushes, and that puts Morph in a huge disadvantage right now. 3v5. The spikes heading towards mid. Oh, Cut might stop them in their tracks. So he has an operator and he wants to play a little bit aggressive, hopes to stop them before they get into a site. But it doesn't seem like he will be able to catch the timing just in time as the spike will be heading towards the sewers.
Dude, what's even better as well, Zero, is that the fact that because they stayed on C for so long and did quite a amount of presence, they actually rotated towards the C. The mind games is happening, and Brand Esports anticipating that they rotate towards his A. Now they're going to be really quick about it, throwing out the Paranoia and even the Death Club. Although there is one member with the rotation, he drops out the Cyber Cage for a little bit of a good measure. But here comes the Shroud Step, going to be committed for that teleport right below Heaven inside Hell.
Yep, 3v5. I don't think that Morph is going to even think about retaking this. And there we have it. They are running towards C, holding on towards their guns. They did fool by this round, so whatever they can get away with, they will have to be content, as Brand will be able to almost certainly get round number 4 here for themselves, and that's going to help the economy. They didn't have the best buy coming towards this round, but still, after what Dispenser did in mid towards famous, as well as the Omen, they will be able to secure this round.
Honestly, what Dispenser has been doing the entire time is just absolutely so nasty. And the thing is this, like I told Gideon in the last game as well, like Reyna has always been like a flex pick to me.
It
because
is?
Reyna is one of the heroes as well. If you do not have frags, you're pretty much skillless. Although your Lair is possibly the best flash in entire game, but if you're not able to get frags on top of it, then that's all you are going to be known for.
Just a flasher.
Yeah, it's just a flasher.
Not a good thing.
I mean, girls, a flasher is never a good thing. I mean, it's a good thing for us guys, but you know, please don't do that in public. But still, Dispenser, really the main fragger for the entire team. His entry frag is amazing. His rotation route, especially, he got this entire map pinned down with that knowledge for himself. So anticipating, expecting, you can definitely put your bats on Dispenser, he's gonna cut you off guard.
And here we have it, Dubstep and Dispenser pushing towards C. That's gonna give so many warning signs. They're like, the Jet and the Reyna both are at C. Everyone, rotate now. We can't handle this with three people. We need five of them to handle against Dubstep as well as Dispenser. But no, it's just poking and prodding, getting information. Fidel able to spot one player out, or at least get the information that Jesse Vash is lurking there. Just the confirmation, of course. But right now, still holding on, hoping that someone from the side of Morph will push in towards that crosshairs. So Morph's playing very, very disciplined.
Yeah, very disciplined there. But Khan was able to put down Borka for good with that pick, with that operator. Really well played too. Now Brent is one man down, but it's definitely not the end of the world because they still have that breach. They have the flashes, and speaking of smokes, there goes Dubstep as Freya was able to spray him down. Same goes for Chick as well. No more initiative, no more engagement towards the sides. Looks like both members of Brent Esports, they will look, they're gonna go for the saves here. But look at the rotations.
Look at the rotations again. Everyone rotates to C, and that leaves A fully open, and Brent spots the weaknesses, will go there straight away. They're gonna get a spike down for sure. Only
left.
The Sova is nearby, so there is no way they can stop the plant, but the retake should be quite simple.
Dude, I love it so much as well, because Brandon was like, you know what, fine, we lost our engages, we lost our initiatives. Well, it's totally fine, we can just rotate. They think we're on C, and now finally they got the plant down. All Brand Eastwood have to do is hold down the corners, hold down the angles, and get ready for an engagement coming up from Morse. Here comes the...
he dinked him!
Dinked him, but not enough to kill him, Sally.
It's Dispenser on the defense. But Freya way too sharp this time, and he's able to get both of the kills. That secures the defuse, and Morph able to breathe a sigh of relief as they get a flawless round against Brand in round number 5.
I mean, you don't call Freya the goddess of the Valkyries for nothing, man.
Absolutely
seriously.
Not.
3 kills on his belt in that last round, absolutely insane. And most importantly, very objective kills too. Getting rid of both the Jet and even the breach as well. Both engages, which was necessary to push towards the sides, really helped set things up for them. But then again, Brand pulling out the mind games, goes for that smart quick rotations too, allowed them to drop the spike. So that's going to be allowing them to get up 1 point for that upgrade.
Yeah, they definitely made the best out of a bad situation here. And still, with that plant able to afford another full buy, utilities might be running a little bit scarce here, but Jesse Vash does have the Neurotheft. Borkum has from the Shadows Ultimate, so they can make those work as they are pushing aggressively towards A long, and that is completely clear for them to take.
But here comes a lot of members of the Brilliant Esports getting ready to get engaged towards this A long. But most importantly, I really would want to see what kind of pickups they want to go for. Because look at this Omen. He is constantly ensuring to see if any rotation coming from the side here or Morph will be denied by him should his Cypher teammate were to fall from that double doors.
Yeah, this Cypher aggressive lurk is pretty interesting. He threw the Cyber Cam on the tree, so if Fat Penguin pushes in aggressively, he's going to tell. Oh, but he heard the sound cue that they use the Cyber Dart, so he knows that the Cyber Cam is on the tree. He's not going to push out. He's going to back off here. He's still causing a lot of noise though, but still, three players here towards A side. Can this work out for Brent?
By the way, beautiful usage of the dark cover and the layer as well. A lot of combos gonna be coming down. Chud has to be really careful as he runs towards the side. But look at the retake coming from the side here of Morph. He's going to be able to hold down that fort.
30
here
seconds
on
left.
Point A. Last member of Brent Esports Isley has to fall back. The lone lurker is now forever alone inside this round of 6.
Yeah, just the timing of everyone looking at different angles. Brent Esports was not able to spot out anyone. In the meantime, Morph somehow just got to the back of everyone. Hitting this wiped out everyone. Only Jesse Vash holding on towards his Vandal. He's not gonna try and make this a reality. He's gonna play it safe and save his gun because they are almost out of cash.
By the way, the Indonesian team turned things around here, tying this call against Brandy Sport from the Philippines here. 3-3. They're coming back into this game, ladies and gentlemen. Really strong. I'm at this point, right? If I'm not mistaken, too, the engagement coming from the side of Morph Esports is slowly, I would say coming online. I think it's just maybe they just need a wake-up call, you know, that warm-up, you know?
Yeah, of course. Getting themselves in the groove, you know, it's a different opponent. They have a different pace. They have a different play style. Right now, they might have gotten a read on how they play, but they might not be ready for this. Look at this. It's going to be a full-on push, full-on rush towards C-Long and see what happens from there. It's gonna be Dubstep. Kondo gets an early Q onto his chin. Famous strikes down Borkum as well. And that's gonna slow down Brand quite a bit. This was not what they expected.
Oh man, that's the thing about like that's the thing about picking operator, or in this case jet operators. It's just such
it's
a nuisance to deal
insane.
with.
It's so silly right now. I mean, eventually, I think they will deal with it some way or another, but we still have to live with it. Dubstep gets a kill on towards Famous with the Blaze Storm, and that's gonna start things off. That's gonna be possible for Brent to take
exactly
B site.
Oh man, I guess in this case, you can definitely tell that our different Dubstep is cutting them down the side. They cut even more. There goes their own jet here. Tiny's now gonna be down to a 2v3. They got control of this B. Now they have to get this spike.
Dubstep!
He gets another one with the triple kill. One more standing. Ladies and gentlemen, can he get this quad for himself? He may not be the Blaze Storm, but he has his sight on that bed, and he will get
God.
Him.
Dubstep with that. Doo-doo-doo-doo-doo gets 4 kills.
Oh my God.
I thought
you were about to drop the beat here, like now, Zero. I was like, what? Is he actually starting
that,
a little with the Dubstep here? DJ Zero?
Oh yeah, you know. great play there from Brent, you know.
Oh, yes.
On an eco round, you get 4 kills on just Dubstep as well as the kill from Jesse Vash, open things up. And that was actually Dubstep's first 4 kills.
Yeah,
surprisingly.
Yeah, first 4. I mean, definitely more.
More will be coming.
Yeah, more will be coming for sure. Like, if you say first 4 kills, like, yeah, first 4 kills, but like, there's still, like, Brent still got another BO2 to play, and
no
I definitely can tell you for sure. He wants that ace for himself here. But, ooh. Anyway, Hunter Spirit is going to be committed for the side here, and actually, he will be able to snipe a one member as well. Fiddle, wow! Big wows coming from the rest of the team here. Famous was able to go for the spray down on Borkum. Two members short here for the side of Brent Eastmore. And with the lair, this Spencer will be able to get the upper hand against their opponent, Reyna Famous.
Definitely, even though they are undermanned, you cannot count Brand out. They've got this dispenser, they've got Dubstep, they can do anything when they are really determined to enter these sites. And still, 3 versus 4. We have just a regroup right now coming from the side of Brand. Looks like they want to hit A, and they might get themselves 2 quick kills on towards the sewers. They get the first on towards Freya. Dubstep, can he get one more? He's chasing, but Soma is running away. He's going to get away to safety, and he's able to hold on before the rotations come in. But look at this, Bren. They are rotating away once again.
Oh my lord, the mind games coming out for this Zero. It's an absolute shame. I'm getting so confused. Brad, what do you want to do? Every time we think you're going to be pushing towards the side from a certain angle, you decide to say like, hey, maybe they're thinking this way. Let's change things up.
Left.
And now currently, they're going to be trying to push towards the speed. They only have 30 seconds here. And I don't think Morph Esports Owen doesn't know about it because he's not pushing through B. He's actually going through double doors.
I mean, this is perfect. I mean, Brad has just been playing with their minds, you know. You think we're going A, nowhere B, but tada, we're at C. And the spike will go down, Dispenser will fall to a spam penguin. Fiddlewild gets a kill onto Dubstep, but Ching will hold on. He has the operator, he will not get one. Cut on the other side, able to get the kill, stops it, stems the bleeding, and they will be able to get the defuse. Very close round though, very close.
And the best part about it, Ching would have been able to hold it down longer if he actually connected that rolling thunder. But let's be honest, it's just shit. It's just freaking
it's
jet.
Just jet things, right?
It's just jet things. That's why I'm so happy when I heard the rumor coming from that Riot will be trying to tweak that operator a little bit. So at least we're not going to be seeing too many combos with that jet op. But there's still going to be that nuisance of that jet shoddy. So, you know, we'll see how later in the future, because currently there is no nurse or anything right now. Only the common patches for certain agents.
Yep. So Kurt as well as Ching both having the operator. We've not been having any operator do so far, but Cut might want to start aggressive towards garage doors. Let's see how it goes. He might get Ching. Ching is just waiting for him. Oh, he's way too fast.
God.
Cut. Get out of here. And he does actually just with Tailwind getting out of there. And he'll hold on to a C.
It's just freaking Jet. Get out of my life, Jet, at this point here. But either way, beautiful backup coming from the time of Morph.
Dispenser.
The Indonesian team still holding strong against the Philippine teams here of Brand Esport. Dispenser gets tagged. He's going to be falling back just for a little bit of safe measure. But Dubstep coming in from Suish here from the Asia. But he's constantly going back and forth. He's waiting to see what else his team's going to be doing because they're currently one man short. They don't have the bridge. So taking the side is going to be a little bit more difficult. But they still have their own flash and smokes.
Yeah, they just do still have the paranoia as well as the leer coming from the Reyna. So definitely picking up the Reyna is a smart choice here, but still, Brent, I think they're still playing their mind games. You know, where are they going? Where is the rest of the teammates? Morph right now, they have no information at all whatsoever. They have no idea where anyone from Brent is. And look at the rotations. Sova is running through a sea, like, hey, they might be coming through a sea. I gotta help out right now. And
30 seconds
it's only
left.
Freya left along at A, and somehow Bren gets that read. Somehow they know only one player is in A.
Mm-hmm, and now beautiful enough as well, with only 20 seconds on the clock, they have to quickly dive right to the max. Beautiful usage of the dark cover, and another Jesse Vash trying to hold down the line as long as possible, trying to delay that incoming retake coming on the side here of Morph Esport. Now look at this, 3v5, Paranoid is going to be able to connect upside, trying to hold down the line. Leo, deal with it away, just one good matches away. Morph was able to get a beautiful kill on Chad. Freya, headshot spray now with a double kill on the Spencer, and Famous will take down Dubstep and Morph. 3 days back, and now they are in the lead by 1 point. Indonesia, all their fans right now, they're going absolutely wow.
Yeah, Morph definitely showing that they can really fight against the best here. And this is the first time they've taken the lead, of course. But look at the scoreline, 4 defuses. Oh, the post-pan situation has not been great for Bren. They've only been able to win mostly rounds with killing. And Bren still definitely has this, it's not over for them yet. They still have another buy round. Let's see if they're able to even things out once again. But it is getting close to the first half. And then when the round stops, we might see a completely different scenario.
Yeah, definitely for sure. And also a little bit concerning for Bren as well, because should they lose this round, they will have to go for this eco. Mm-hmm. Whereas Morph, they currently have a very stable economy.
Yeah.
But let's be honest, Bren Esports members, each of their members, they are very quick to turn things around when the game really calls for it. But anyway, Dubstep with the Sheriff is going to be able to take 1 point for himself. He's literally only one frag away from getting that ultimate, whereas Chud here has only needed a 3. Ooh, but Dispenser! Chud tries to go for the flick, but Dispenser is just way faster than you. But anyway, that's going to be the trade for here on FiddleWow.
Yep. Oh, a lot of kills going on towards that side. Ching as well as Dubstep both outstriking. Jesse Vash will fall, leaving only 2 left for Bren. But where will they go? We still have no idea, as Ching still holding on towards the spike on towards mid. He's hearing the footsteps from Famous though. He actually doesn't know this. He might get caught out here as he's holding towards deep in towards mid. Borkum has rotated. Look at the lurk coming from Borkum. Oh, he spots him out. Famous gets a hit of Ching. That's a spike down, and everyone's gonna be running towards the spike. Borkum, can he do something about this all alone? He's lurking towards the garage, but Freya somehow has his number.
30 seconds left.
Mm-hmm, but looks like Borkum, he knows 30 seconds is left, but he's not gonna go for the save. He's trying to go for the spike, but Freya will put Borkum down to the ground. And looks like Bren Esports, they will have to go for another save. But finally, Zero, we're seeing a 2-point difference between this team. And Morph Esports is at 2 points.
Yeah, Morph definitely is proving their mettle here, able to get a full buy and forcing Bren to go into an eco here. Mm-hmm. Bren has to rethink their strategy a little bit. It seems like they haven't been able to close out these rounds. And they're forced on eco, of course, so this round is not going to be as important, but they are saving for the last round of this half. So let's see how fast or aggressive Bren can play with only just pistols.
Yeah, and that's pretty much why we see Dispenser even picking up the Spectre too, because he's like, I need to try to drop as many weapons as possible. Although sure, Bren Morph Esports will be still have the money to come in for the last round, but still doesn't matter. Ooh, here comes the Fallout, gonna be able to connect and force it cut the D-scope from an operator. But here comes the Clubber, here comes the reaction, even with the Leer, trades are happening all across the map. But Chud with the double kill, but Isaac is punished by Chink with the headshot with the Sharon. Let me remind you again, Bren Esports, they're the one on the eco round. They're the one that saved a weapon here. And still going to town. Freya was able to find one, but Spencer picking up that operator. Finds one, go for the tank. Barely misses. But Ching the gun is stepping up with the team. And as Spencer will end Famous down to the ground.
They made it work. You know, we lost with rifles, whatever. We've got pistols. We made it work. We rushed to our C. We got 2 kills. And we got a spike down. Morph, despite their best efforts, that was just Bren all the way. The Spencer coming up huge with the operator. Mm. As well as Dubstep opening the site with his Blade Storm. And right now, Bren, off of that victory, is going to look at a very great economy heading towards the half, of course. But look at Morph. Double operators.
Oh man, double operators. This is the last round as well. They'll literally say, I have dominated more, but here comes Chud with the jet off combination. But then with the reaction plays, he knows that Chud might try to go for this pick once again, which he has been commonly doing at these double doors.
Yeah.
He drops down the cyber cage just to force him to go back. But look at the rotation here coming from Bren Esports. They know this is the last round. They're taking this nice and slow as they push from the A long towards his A side.
Oh, look at them using from the shadows to great effect, using on towards heaven, knowing that rotation coming. Dubstep gets killed, those Famous. But can they get more? Fat Penguin still playing towards heaven, trying to spray through, trying to connect the wall bank, but not able to. As the spike will go. What was that? Oh, okay, Dubstep just doing a little dance there before the opponents do come in. He wants to get that little jiggle, that little exercise before he goes for the battle. Here comes the Bladestorm, because the Operator, here comes the Rolling Thunder. Is going to buy so much time, slowing them down. They are dazed, they are dizzy, and they are just waiting for it to end. Oh, the fault lines, come on, come on. Okay. Gren, they have bought so much time. The spike is almost gone there. 20 seconds left. Just imagine the kill to Spraya. He will fall Volcom straight in between. And the spray through the smoke. Volcom and Thumbstep clears things out. Gren able to win it out and tie it off in the first half. What a fantastic defensive round.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're seeing like a beautiful tennis game. They're going back and forth at it. They're literally going head to head here. Now, finally, I believe this is the first time we actually see inside this entire group stage where both teams actually tied it out in the first half, 6-6.
Yep. What a half. I mean, this wasn't the scoreline we were expecting. We were expecting Brand to roll over more, but Morph says, now, we're going to fight all the way towards the end. They even took the lead at one point for 2 points, but Brand being Brand, they have able to even things out, and we are heading towards the second half on an even scoreline.
I mean, yeah, that's because, you know, Morph is saying, you know, like that Indo Pride.
Yeah,
right?
Indo Pride.
Like, we're Indo Pride, man. If we're going to go down, we're going to go down hard. But then again, they're going so hard at Brand Esports. Brand Esports like, you're going to go hard at us, we're going to go hard back at you. Both Philippines and Indonesia right now. Absolutely so happy here.
Yeah, Laban Pinas, as they say. But look at this.
Yes.
Morph pushing aggressively towards A. Only two inside of A. But Borkum has already lurked so far. But Freya waiting for the lurk. Absolutely perfect positioning there. Cut able to get a kill onto his dubstep. Famous with the headshot on for Dispenser as well. This side is wide open like a clam. And Cut will be able to reap in his rewards as they will get the spike planted.
Oh man, Morph Esport, one tap hero as well. And the thing is, if they're able to secure this first round as well, Morph is going to be having a beautiful 2 points lead by themselves. But not to say it's by default, but by analysis. And instantly, Famous, you know what he's famous for? Just pushing right into your face and making you so uncomfortable.
Yeah, as well as getting those headshots. I mean, looking, we might see a 50-60% headshot percentage here coming from side of Famous, and he's looking for more. I want those great stats as he's pushing from the back lines. Leave it for me, leave it to me. Let me get the kill. Look at that. No, Freya's gonna just KS it. No, it's mine. Thank you. Flawless round coming from Morph on the attack. Brand will be starting off this half with a disadvantage in terms of buy.
Yeah, but still, really great start coming from the side here, Morph. Not losing a single member and getting a flawless round off and taking it away from Brand Esport. But of course, as you guys know, this is Valorant. Anything can happen. Anything can happen here. But anyway, Dispenser, I think he wants to pull all the stops here because he is bringing up the shorty here.
The strongest gun in Valorant
the
here.
Most being picked up. The most broken
it's
gun
It's a 200
ever.
Gun side, $200 sidearm.
Exactly.
Hashtag balance.
Oh, man. Speaking of balance, they might just need a balance change. Ching starts popping off like the previous game anyway. Yeah. By the way, coming back to this one between Morph and Brandy, he's probably 7-6 here. And now Morph taking it nice and easy. Although despite this being the eco round, they are totally not underestimating Brand Esports firepower at all.
Yeah, but look at where Jesse Vash is. He might actually catch them off guard playing at such a close angle. Ching is just there to bait them to push in a little bit further. Let's see if it works out. But if it doesn't, then Brand is just going to be one man down throughout this defense. Looking from the side of Morph, they are poised to take towards C. They have four members here. And they are going in right now.
Ooh, anyway, that's the tag. It's going to be able to try to fall free for John once again gets away with it. And he almost went in with his sister with his team. He will be able to survive despite being hit by the fault line. Two members of Brand Esport instantly falling down from the C defense. And Favorite and Fat Pan was still going on strong. Last man standing. He has to try to make the play, but they're going for a couple of pre-fire through the dark cover, through the smoke. And Famous will be so famous in this round because he got 3 kills on his belt.
And it's a flawless round as well. Very clean, great round there from Morph. Morph Brand wasn't able to do anything, but right now they should be able to with the buys they have. 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe the fifth Vando as well on Borkum, or maybe he'll be going for a little bit more utility. Nope, he's gonna go for the Vando whatsoever. Just gonna go into this round full force. Well, on the side of Morph, they're still playing with two Spectres. This is gonna be a very precarious round from the side of Brand. They cannot lose this round because if they do, their economy will be in the gutter.
I mean, that's for sure, in the gutter for sure. And Brand Esports, this is the round loss, so they're going to be getting that bonus 2,900 credits. And whereas Morph, I love it, two members, they're not going to be committing that buy. They still want to work with that economy. Ooh, but here comes the spray up. This man's going to be initially getting a beautiful pickup. There's the dismiss, going to be able to sustain as he will be able to back away from the firing power of Morph Esports members. But that's a lot of information he gathered from the rest of the team from the engagement at A-Long.
Yep, and the rotations have already came in there, but Morph might pull out a Brand here. They might just, you know, rotate on towards the other sides, but the other sides have eyes on them as well. We have Borkum playing towards C, Jesse Vash towards B as well. So it's just going to be this three-man stack on towards A. And Famous checking all the corners, hoping to get someone, hoping to pick off someone playing aggressive before they initiate in.
Dude, I also love the fact that you actually, you said pulling a Brand. You make it sound like it's a magic trick coming up on the rest of the team, yeah? But then here comes the corner checking with the Spectre, but suddenly Dispenser was able to follow up with, alongside with Dubstep, headshot kill. Fiddle Wild making all the wild plays and able to get a double one on Dubstep. Then main fragments are all down. Famous is coming in hot with the rest of the team here, and we're looking at the 1v2. They're gonna be planting down the spike. The spike has been planted. Last man standing. He gets blinded by the layer, but he's already safe and cover. What the headshot pickup coming in from Famous is just so good. And with that, Morph Esports finally from a 2-point difference, we're finally gonna see a 3-point deficit.
Yep, great plays there from Morph. Really coming in hot here in the second half there. And right now, Brand is going to be forced on eco once again. Will we see or a judge coming from the side of Dubstep? We'll wait and see. But, I see something. It's a shotgun. It's just a shorty.
Yeah, it's just a shorty on the hands of Dispenser. But of course, you must also understand as well, this is Haven, right? Mm-hmm. The bread and butter for most of this team. But most importantly, this is an attacking side of map. Not really heavily favored, but by stats itself, it is an attacking side event. So the fact that Morph was able to rack up tight enough points, but here comes Famous coming from the E-Log, picking things up, and then 9 Dubstep with that jet tailwind waves. And now, Brandy Swan, one man short here.
Yeah, Famous has been just so good in getting these picks, and I'm not sure of his current scoreline, but it has to be something really spectacular right now. Famous, as well as the rest of Morph, will back off right now. They know that they have forced a lot of utilities and maybe looking to get something else on the other side of the map. But Brand might have gotten a read on that as well. The rotations are coming in fast. They're running towards C, they're running towards B, and hopefully they make it in time before Morph goes in full force.
And the best part about it is that it's a clean read coming from Brand Esports as well. Yeah. Like, they realized, they're holding A for a little bit too long and there's absolutely nothing happening. So they realized, maybe Morph also going to be playing the mind games and go for this rotation, and so will they. And with that Dark Tower as well, their answer has been heard and questioned. But we've been about timing with the fall line, but again, Famous and Prayer just a little bit too good with that pickup. Still going strong, jump pushing forward towards Garage. He's getting ready to mold down the last member of Brand Esports. But he's not going to go for the save. He's going to see if he can try to get a couple of frags or maybe even an exit kill with this Sheriff.
Yeah, these back-to-back flawless rounds will eventually really help out Morph in the long run. But what a tough round right now. Brand keeping the next round. Morph is leading currently at double digits already. Looks like Dubstep will go for the old faithful here. Going for the operator. Hopefully, he's able to get something done here playing that aggressive. But the rest of the players of Brand, they do have to step up a little bit. Ching as well, Jesse Vash, they have to do a little bit more. I almost thought they went for double operators there on the defensive side.
Yeah, I thought it was at that point, I was like, oh my god, is Brand Esports about to throw all the cards on the table? Yeah. Are they going to go all in with this double up? But anyway, just for good measures, they're going to be bringing out the rifles because they also realized that Morph Esports playing style is a little bit more aggressive, especially when the game is only 3 points away for Morph to take this win.
Dubstep tries to get someone on towards sewers, but not able to get the wipe it. Get one! Were we expecting anything else?
Nothing, dude. It's just Jet. I'm just like, it's Jet. But then again, it's just Dubstep. Yes, it's just Dubstep too. So now we got two things to blame it.
It's Jet and Dubstep. It's a nerf Dubstep, Give him one leg so he can't go as fast.
Exactly. VAC that vacuum. Vac Dubstep in this case. By the way, coming back to the game, 5v4 here. This is going to be slowing them down a little bit. Although, yes, they lost one of their heavy smokers, but they still have the jets. Crash that. Shake the guard. Coming in strong here. Picking off Famous and deny him from being any more aggressive here.
Yeah, he spots them out as well. That was the Reyna using Empress. Borkum strikes fast, strikes hard on Truth's Reyna. Freya, leaving it to a 2v5, and this is looking like Brand's round, at least for the second half. They haven't had too much success when they switch to the defensive side, so this might be just the start of a huge comeback here. Ching gets a kill on those Fidoao, and it's just left down to Cut. Can he get something done here? Yeah, he gets one. He gets Dispenser. He gets Dubstep as well. This might be something, as it's down to a 2v1. He's just pre-firing across the corner. Goes aggressive. Now, Barkham, he has it. He knows he's going to come for it, and he just holds the angle. They will be able to save the operator as well. I think, did they scoreboard now, please? Yeah, they saved the operator. And, woo, Bren, they almost slipped through the hands.
At the same time, it was also almost a flawless as well for Bren. But yeah. Chud stepped up, for Indonesia here, mm-hmm. for more of eSport, and was able to pick up two beautiful kills. Could have been a third too, but I guess he tailwind too much towards the open there, where Barker was pretty much very prepared for him. Man, Zero, this is very, very close here. But then again, Mars still has enough economy to go for another full buy round for themselves here. But if should they lose in this second one, this might be a little bit concerning.
Yep, Dispenser as well as the Ching playing aggressively through a sewer. Ching gets the kill though somehow, someway. They get the second and that's a spike down. They have all the information. Feeder Wild peaks at exact perfect timing. Here rolling comes the Rolling Thunder going through everyone, but the smoke is proving too difficult. He's trying to spray through there randomly. Fault Lion survives a little bit more time. He's being pushed. The reload! The reload! Come on! Feeder Wild gets the kill for Ching and it's down to a 3v3. They retrieve the spike on the side of Morph. Bren right now has rotated, but Dispenser is holding on. Oh, Nero Dev comes out, getting all the information they need. They see everyone, and from that, they are going to make the exact correct play, which is to go A, because that just baited them. They just made Bren think that they're going to rotate towards C or B, because they saw a lot of rotations towards A, but nah, 600 IQ, I'm going back towards A.
And also at the same time, it's full reason why for him to go back to A2 for the Cypher Jet too, because understanding the fact that both Omen and Cypher, they're really great at holding down the side and just being a very strong anchor, regardless of whether they're attacking or defending. But Chad's gonna tailwind right to the side here with the Blazestone, but realizing there's no one here from any corner or angle, he's gonna re-equip back that gun and dubstep with the operator. Just getting ready for this retake, not being too aggressive, just wait time with his team as he's holding down this angle from that ailing.
Yeah, they have no flash though. They have to rely on just this Dispenser dubstep going in, as well as the information you can get. Dubstep gets one, Morkums gets a second, 2v1, and they get it all. Jesse Bash with the nice last kill. Bren is able to clean up, and they will make it an 8th round on the board for the side of Bren. Nicely done on the retake. Not overzealous, not good one, but a coordinated attack that got them the upper hand.
Oh, dude, this is really great for them. Although, yes, Bren is slowly working with that, balancing their own economy. More for this case, this is their last round. But then again, also at the same time, even if Morph were to lose this round, that this is going to be their third consecutive loss. So, in other words,
they will have enough buy as well.
Exactly. They'll still get enough buy for the next round with that 2,900 credits. But of course, I don't think they really want to lose at that point.
No, of course not. I mean, getting to 11, that puts a lot of pressure on towards Bren, but the economy control on both of these teams are just top-notch.
Yes, top-notch indeed. They both fully understand this, man. And of course, Haven is pretty much the bread and butter for all of us Valorant players. So it all comes down to who has it better when it comes down to those pickoffs.
You're coming down. They have went down towards mid, but Dubstep strikes her first onto his cut, and that's the end for the side of Morph. Heavily nerfed. Dubstep might be able to get the second. The flick doesn't connect. But he's off to a safe position. Famous gets hit by Paranoia. He has to back up a little bit. Double Leer used to try and buy some space. Barkham and Ching strikes hard. Gets two kills. Dubstep gets his second. And then the spike carrier down. Freya stuck towards mid. And Dispenser will dispense him off. Flawless round for Bren. Finally, they close the gap. And it's just 1 point difference between both of them.
Oh my god, Zero, we're going back and forth, back and forth. And now in this case, both of these teams here, a lot of pride, so much pride coming from both of us. All the fans are absolutely going wild down. Guys, whoever's back at home, seriously, comment down in the comment section below. Give them a lot of love, because both of these teams, they're not giving an inch at all.
Not a single centimeter, in fact. They are going for another full buy here from the side of Morph. Like you said, their economy management is perfect. But can they switch things up? Morph have to change things a little bit. They have given away 3 rounds in a row towards Bren after getting the first 4. So Bren have adapted, can do the same.
The thing is this, right? At this point, it's more dangerous for Morph as well, because this is actually the third consecutive round. So yep. If Morph were to lose here and their economy, their team is not looking that great at all, then they will have to go for that 2 full round eco. And I don't think Morph wanna do that, because Bren will be able to top things off and get that rack of so many points before they clutch this round.
That was very low health left on towards the Reyna. Borkum almost had him, but still able to back off. 2 Leers were used, so the Reyna is pretty much a useless agent right now unless she gets some kills.
Mm-hmm, still pushing on the line. There goes the Cloudburst with the Tailwind combo just to get a little bit more cover. Barely gets out of the race. Oh, Freya going to go to the top while Jesse Vash drops that. Then again, the nice charge. The Spencer on the other side gets a beautiful spray down, and we're looking down to a 3v3. Tying things down. Reyna not looking to help me. But Fat Penguin stepping things up for the team. He spots him up. Go for the snipe. Dubstep gets one. 1v2, but sadly, Famous going for the round. Flanks with the night. Dubstep and more respawn. Taking the game back towards their face. Not even kidding, though. We went. And the game's on the line. Yeah. More Esports is gonna come online.
Fat Penguin just stepped up huge there, getting that 2 kills. So did Fiddle. I mean, they just held down the side that they took so strong. You know, Bren might have been a little bit overzealous as well, not going for the retake. Instead, just wanting to trickle in one by one after they got the first 2 kills. Remember, it was 5v3, and it became a 3v1 out of a sudden.
Yes, but this is the round.
This is the most important round in Bren's life. For the next 15 minutes at least, as they will be forced to match mat point if they're not careful here. Bren, on the defense, they have to cross all their T's and dot all of their I's, or however that goes. Oh, Morkut! No! Gas ahead of Borkum, and that's gonna open things up for the side of Morph. Bren, one man down. Dispenser has to step up here, as well as Dubstep. They have to get really meaningful kills to just stop the train that is Morph that keeps just chugging and chugging and chugging forward.
Yes, and also at the same time, Chad was pretty much just like, surprise, my friend, you're gonna die here.
Yeah.
Welcome to the smokes. But anyway, coming back to the game here, we see Ching holding out this angle here with the dark cover and getting ready to pull out that flash. Ooh, but as he comes out to the source, Famous was so prepared as well. Ching wasn't really having his gun out either. But anyway, Jesse Vash gets picked up by Shot. It's going to be down to a 2v5. Scratch that, made it down to a 1v5 in the last man standing. Dispenser, can he clutch the round? He finds one. He's looking for the most opportunity moment because he wants a kill.
Oh no!
But he barely missed a kill. He should have taken a shot. Now he's missing everything.
Oh, no.
And Fat Penguin getting the headshot with that wall bang. A beautifully flawless round for Morph.
Match point.
The score is 12-9, and this 0 is match point.
What an unexpected turn of events here. Morph reaches map point, and Bren right now are in a very dire situation. Dispenser, the trigger discipline was perfect, but what happened after that was a little bit dicey. Misses the shot up, giving away the his positioning, and just completely whips his spray. That is something they have to look at. Sure, it doesn't happen again in order to move forward.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, last round. Bren has to turn things around as well. I don't think they want to give up this first game either.
No, definitely not. This was one of those matches that they were expected to win. I mean, Morph is on paper a weaker team. Bren has all the pedigree they need, all the experience they have. They should have been able to make this round their win, if not much closer than this. But Morph right now on the teeming edge of taking the first map. Bren, this is your last chance.
Mm-hmm. By the way, Ching at the C-Long chubby here. And that's giving a lot of information towards his team, saying like, hey, C-Long is very empty. But then at the same time, they're getting nice and tall. Oh my lord, starting things up and getting rid of one of the main fragments of Bren Esports too. Although sure, there is still the Breach of the Jet, which is what they need for their defense and retake. But they need Dispenser's firepower if they really want to go toe-to-toe with their opponent's Jet Chud.
Definitely, and looks like it's going to be a hit. We have Dubstep as well as Jesse Vash. They are their last line of defense before they're forced to retake. Dubstep, can he come up huge in this push? There is still plenty of utilities ready to be used here. As here they come. Oh, the shot not gonna connect on towards dubstep. Pops the ultimate. Blaze Storm will be used. Second Leer will be used by Famous as the spike. Go down. Paranoia does connect. And the retake is coming.
Oh, anyway, Fall Angle, they try to force him back. Dubstep still holding out the A-Link, but the Dark Cover is going to make this really hard for him to go for that side bait. But Fiddle, wow, picking on Jesse Vine from the heaven. And Dubstep getting ready to jump right in with that Blaze Storm. Going to be coming out through the smoke as well. Smoke's going to be coming up. Goes for the angle spot. No. Sally gets picked up by Chuck, but Jiggly and his still staying strong for the team. But Sally is not going to be good enough. As Chuck will see you the last round here with two men standing, and the score will be 13-9.
What an unexpected result coming in from the side of Morph. They've able to topple one of the titans in this group, and that's gonna put Brand Esports in a very precarious situation. They tied against AHQ, which was great. Mm-hmm. Right now, they are looking to at best tie against Morph, which is, you know, not the situation they expected themselves to be in.
And the thing is this about this as well, like although a lot of people, especially us as well, we were expecting Brand to be again.
Yeah.
Morph probably this morning was just like, because they were the first game for today, probably they're just warming up. They just woke up, and now finally after playing two rounds with Enter in this third BO2 of today, they're like, Brandy's come at me. I have fans. I have people rooting for me from my country. I am going to go all out. So there is that big Indo pride here, and really well played coming out from this team for taking that first game.
Yep, definitely. I mean, that was just a spectacular to watch. The takes, the retakes, the just the frags themselves. I mean, those were definitely on point from all the players. Kurt especially, he was just wow. I mean, 6 first bloods on him. Look at his stats: 22 kills, 13's death. I mean, he was definitely the MVP of the match.
Yeah, and of course, he even got 6 first blood, which I already said during the in-game as well. Like, he's definitely going to be the one who has the most first blood pickup, but that's because he is a jet and he fully utilizes it.
He's just a jet.
Yeah, he's just a jet. And then the best part, even Brand Esports jet not too far behind, he got first blood pickups too. So, yeah, it's just jets right at this point here. So I can't wait until jet gets a little bit more nerfed. A little bit, make game more fair, okay? It's a little bit more better. But then again, kudos to both for this team here in that first game. Really gave it them all. Although, yes, this first game, if I'm not mistaken, is actually Brand Esports' pick. Brand's pick on the map of Haven here. Mm-hmm. So really unfortunate that Brand was not able to win on their map pick. But there is still the second. Remember, this is the best of two here. Mm-hmm. And of course, is this match will not like directly decide who's going to be the top two teams, but it just ensures that one of these two teams will have a better spot and a better chance of being that two teams to go towards this playoff.
Yep, definitely. I mean, Bind, even though it is a Morph's map pick, Brand will be starting on defense, which is the more favorite side for the side of a Bind.
Oh yeah, that's very true.
Yeah, so Brand will have that advantage going in, and if they get themselves to a great start, like 10-2 score, 3-9 score line, they're going to be able to roll over once they reach the attacking side. Yeah. But if Morph to pull off upsets like this once again, Brand might face themselves in a very dire situation. They'll be down with one tie and one loss. That's not going to be a position that they want to be in.
Maybe it's just a couple, if we actually try to like break it up between both this team and their gameplay, I believe there's just a lot of, I wouldn't say a lot of callous mistakes. It's just that there's just some areas where I get it, you're very calm. That both of these teams, or these players in particular, like Dispenser, both of these Reyners in this case, or both of these Jets, they're very confident they're able to go for this pickup, but at the same time, it's a high risk with high reward, but at the same time with high amount of punishment. Mm-hmm. So every time you go for this first picks, and if you were to fail, especially like major agents that's being picked up like Breaches and even Cypher, you lose a lot of things, and it depending on whether you're offensive or attacking or defensive here.
I agree completely. I mean, they just played, you know, a little bit too aggressive, gave away too many free kills. True. That just created, you know, such a advantage from the side of Morph that just tilted in their favor. But enough from us. The panel has to say about map number one between Brand and Morph.